Childhood. The small child sang. The mother, outstretched on the low bed, with anguish moaned. Fair form pain should possess not long, for ever nigher death hovered around her head. I hearkened there this moan, and heard even there that song. The child was but 5 years, and close to the lattice I made a sweet noise with games and with his laughter bright, and the one mother, aside this being the livelong day, caroling joyously, coughed hoarsely all the night. The mother went to sleep among them that sleep alway, and the blithe little lad began anew to sing. Sorrow is like a fruit. God doth not therewith weigh earthward the branch strong, yet but for the blossoming. Death in life. We pass, these sleep, beneath the shade where deep-leaved boughs bend o'er the furrows the great reaper ploughs, and gentle summer winds in many sweep whirl in eddying waves the dead leaves over the graves. And the living sigh, forgotten ones, so soon your memories die. Ye never more may list the wild bird's song, or mingle in the crowded city throng. Ye must ever dwell in gloom, mid the silence of the tomb. And the dead reply, God giveth us his life. Ye die, your barren lives are tilled with tears. For glory, ye are clad with fears. O living ones, O earthly shades, we live, your beauty clouds and fades. Epitaph. He lived and ever played, the tender smiling thing. What need, O earth, to have plucked this flower from blossoming? Hadst thou not then the birds with rainbow colours bright, the stars and the great woods, the one wave, the blue sky? What need to have wrapped this child from her thou hadst placed him by, beneath those other flowers to have hid this flower from sight? Because of this one child, thou hast no more of might. O star-girt earth, his death yields thee not higher delight. But ah, the mother's heart with woe for ever wild, this heart whose sovereign bliss brought forth so bitter birth. This world, as vast as thou, even thou, O sorrowless earth, is desolate and void because of this one child. Have you nothing to say for yourself? Speak, if you love me, gentle maiden, or haunt no more my lone retreat. If not for me thy heart be laden, why trouble mine with smiles so sweet? Ah, tell me why so mute, fair maiden, whene'er as thus so oft we meet. If not for me thy heart be, Aideen, why trouble mine with smiles so sweet? Why, when my hand unconscious pressing still keep untold the maiden dream, in fancy thou art thus caressing the while we wander by the stream. If thou art pained when I am near thee, why in my path so often stray? For in my heart I love, yet fear thee, and fain would fly, yet fondly stay. How butterflies are born. The dawn is smiling on the dew that covers the tearful roses. Lo, the little lovers that kiss the buds and all the flutterings in jasmine bloom and privet of white wings that go and come and fly and peep and hide with muffled music, murmured far and wide. Ah, springtime, when we think of all the lays that dreamy lovers send to dreamy maze, of the proud hearts within a billet bound, of all the soft silk paper that men wound, the messages of love that mortals write, filled with intoxication of delight. Written in April and before the Maytime shredded and flown, playthings for the wind's playtime. We dream that all white butterflies above, who seek through clouds or waters souls to love, and leave their lady mistress to despair, to flirt with flowers as tender and more fair, are but torn love letters that through the skies flutter and float and change to butterflies.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.